CNN Breaking News.
Some breaking news. Moments ago, Pope Francis vowing to take the Catholic Church abuse scandals head on.
Yes, speaking at the Vatican on the final day of the historic four-day summit on clergy abuse, the Pope calling priests who abuse children, quote, tools of Satan, and vowing the church will protect children from, quote, ravenous wolves. CNN's Rosa Flores is live in Rome for us. What else did you hear, Rosa, that might have struck a chord with you?
You know, from listening to Pope Francis on day four of this summit and also listening to his remarks on day one, it really doesn't appear that he's delivering on his own message, Christy, because he started this summit with very strong words, saying that he was looking for concrete measures at the end of this summit. And while we heard him talk, like you mentioned, using the word Satan for anyone who abuses children and that, you know, abuse should not be covered up, we're already seeing some reaction from survivors on social media who say that this is all, you know, things that they have heard before from the Catholic Church, and that what they're missing is the when and the how. How is clergy sex abuse going to end? What is exactly going to happen to those who abuse and to those who cover up abuse? And so in these closing remarks by Pope Francis, what we saw was the Pope giving us and giving Catholics around the world a look at the abuse situation, both globally and historically, going back to pagan times, and then listing eight different points. And some of those points include protecting children, taking the issue with seriousness to bring abusers to justice, requiring criteria for the selection of priests, accompanying survivors. So a lot of the things that we've already heard the church say in the past. Now, from talking to survivors here in Rome throughout these 4 days, a lot of them say that right now they have their faith on civil authorities because we know that there are civil investigations going on around the world in the United States, in Chile, in other countries. In the United States specifically, we know that there are at least two federal probes, one in Pennsylvania, one in New York. There are state investigations, at least a dozen of those, by attorneys general that are investigating depending on the powers of their state. So Dave and Christy, we're working to get some video reaction from survivors on this. But based on what we've seen online so far, there appears to be disappointment because Pope Francis was talking about wanting concrete measures. And in his closing statement, we just didn't see those.
So those that want changes, that want accountability, unfortunately, don't hold your breath. Rosa Flores, thank you for that reporting.
Rosa, thank you. Father Edward Beck, CNN religion commentator, is with us now. Father Beck, it's always so good to see you. I want to get your take on what she just said, that they are looking for concrete answers, but the when and the how that's going to happen, even 4 days after all these conversations, that is still missing. Do you fear for this religion?
Well, Christy, I think the intent was always, even by the end of the summit, that Pope Francis would lay out these principles, and it wasn't going to be a detailed minutia of exactly how all of those principles would spin out, but certainly that has been discussed during these days. So, for example, one of the eight principles that Rosa referred to is this united approach by bishops. Well, one of the issues going into this was, how are bishops going to be held accountable like everybody else? Who's going to monitor the bishops?
Right. Bishops so during can't investigate bishops, essentially. Is that right?
Yeah, they can't investigate only themselves. So Cardinal Supich from Chicago laid out a very clear plan by which the metropolitan of the archdiocese, the archbishop, would indeed begin investigation of any bishop accused with a lay team and then make a recommendation to Vatican for immediate removal. So some of the specifics of what Pope Francis laid out have already been discussed in the meeting, and he kind of summarized, I think, what was important.
Well, we have a cardinal who yesterday we got word who said that he knows there was documentation of sexual abuse that was destroyed. Do you think, I think there are a lot of people at home that are sitting here thinking, is this church safe for my children? To that you say what?
I say that it's the safest in the United States that it's ever been since 2002. Zero tolerance has been implemented in the United States since 2002. And so much of what we're hearing about the abuse itself occurred before that. The cover-up, however, and how it was then dealt with when bishops found out about it, that is one of the main issues. And I think what was most surprising to me about this conference, out of 190 participants, you had only 10 women. But the three women who spoke stole the show. There was a Nigerian nun there, Sister Veronica Openibo, who's worked in Africa, and she said, if you think this isn't a problem in sub-Saharan Africa or in Asia, I can tell you I have been there. So yes, there are other problems, but don't let the bishops there tell you this does not exist here. It's a problem. She took that group to task. And then the journalist, the Mexican journalist, Valentina Alizraki, she was mesmerizing for that whole group. She stood there, and I have to give you her quote. She said to the bishops, now this is a mother speaking, if you do not decide in a radical way to be on the side of children, mothers, families, civil authority, you are right to be afraid of us, because we journalists who seek the common good, we will be your worst enemies. Mm-hmm. And so she was saying, we are going to have you accountable. And you need women, you need mothers, you need fathers in this group. You can't keep talking to yourself. And I think the Pope and the others are beginning to realize this is a wider issue. He said it himself. This is a worldwide problem, mm-hmm. abuse. And we have to see it as a worldwide problem, but the church has to deal with it specifically. And I think now we're going to see now the implementation of that after this conference has ended.
And some transparency and specifics so desperately needed. Father Edward Beck, I'm sorry we're out of time. Thank you so very much. We appreciate your insight as always. And as we're wrapping up here, this conversation, the Pope, as he delivers Sunday Mass.